step one in the turnaround project. There's a lot of work to do, but together we will take back and reclaim the greatness of this nation. We will return it to a sound financial footing. We will stop out of control government spending. We won't be about raising anyone's taxes, and we'll make sure that this country moves forward again. Thank you.
Well, that was Michelle Bachmann of Minnesota. Can these two parties work together to control their spending? We are back with our debate. Joining me now, Erica Payne and Mark Mattson. And with me in studio, I've got Mike Santoli and Dennis Neal. And Eric, I want to start with you on that because, again, we saw so much referendum on the economy last night. 62% of voters overall, when they walked out the door, said it was about the economy and they are concerned about deficits in this country. Erica, do you think that Congress can work together overall, both sides of the aisle, and begin to cut waste, cut at least $100 billion maybe?
Well, I mean, the thing is, I don't think there's all that much to cut. You know, the fact of the matter is you've got to get the economy going, and we have gotten it going. There's been private sector job growth for the last 9 months. We were in a horrible position at the end of the Bush administration, losing 750,000 jobs the last month he was in office. And so we're moving in the right direction. You know, people are frustrated, though. It's not fast enough. It's not strong enough. I totally understand why people made the choice they made, but can we just go back to something that Mark said earlier.
Mark, you
said that Democrat and socialists are the same thing. And, you know, I think that we have a real opportunity here with Republicans in charge of the Congress for people to come together and try to find some areas of agreement. And, you know, I'm not a socialist. I went to one of the best business schools in the country. I have worked in the private sector, you know, and just coming out with names like that is not helpful to any kind of debate. And I really think you should think carefully. Our country has a lot of work to do, and we need to figure out ways to work together.
Point taken. But let me go to Mark on kind of what we're talking about, and that is cutting spending in Washington, Mark. And I can think of several ideas: automakers, Fannie Freddie, maybe stopping some of the stimulus programs from getting jump started this year. I mean, there's many ways that government could cut. Give me some examples.
Yeah, they have to start off by just admitting that it's a mess, first of all. I mean, I think what this Republican Congress can start to do is, number one, no new stimulus. That's got to stop. Number two, stop an additional tax on cap and trade. Number three, if they can slow down the health care, that's going to increase additional costs and taxes. And they're going to have to stop spending, and someone has to wake up. And you know, it's one thing to say, you know, we're not socialists, but where does it stop? You know, when is the president going to own the problem in the economy? You know, Cheryl was going back to villainizing Bush again. You know, it's when is Obama going to say, yes, it's my problem. The stimulus has to stop. And all this government spending isn't helping.
Okay.
The best way to turn a recession into a Great Depression is all this socialistic spending.
So let's consider the fact.
Start acting like a free market proposal instead of acting like a socialist. Sorry, but that's the same policies.
Mark, let's consider two things. Number one, China is spending $600 billion to build an infrastructure in their country that is appropriate for a 21st century global economy.
They have money, Erica. We don't.
Roads and bridges. They have made a decision and stimulus. I mean, the fact of the matter is government spending is more stimulative than tax cuts for the wealthiest 2%, which on a list of what is stimulus, tax cuts for the top 2% are the 11th most stimulative thing you can do. So that is not a good idea to extend tax cuts to those 2%.
Mark, really quick, because I want to move. Go ahead.
So now we went from a socialist example to a communist example. The average GDP in China is $3,000. It's $47,000 here. I think they ought to be emulating us, not the other way around.
No, hold on, Erica, and that was my point. The Chinese have the money, and that was my point, Erica. Dennis, there's another issue here. Last night could have been a referendum on House Speaker Nancy Pelosi. They've been spending and spending and spending for the last 2 years under her watch.
It sure has, and if you're a Democrat today, the Obama message should be, you know what, America? I'm sorry, we lost touch with what you want, and now we're going to change. But instead, you're going to see the face of denial. Look at what Nancy Pelosi was saying yesterday, as quoted in the Wall Street Journal this morning. She came out and she basically said, we've taken this country in a new direction, and we are not going back to the failed policies of the past. Did she see that red map? Did she see that crimson tide? I'd say Americans disagree, but Democrats here are in denial, and that could endanger their comeback.
From a market's perspective, Mike, I'm thinking to myself, that does not signal to me everybody coming together and maybe working things out. That signals to me more gridlock.
No, it doesn't signal people coming together, but I also think that we have to stop thinking this is some unique period in time. In 82, Reagan's approval rating lower than Obama's. He had a reversal kind of midterm election. And Clinton did the same thing in 94. So we basically have these. We have these sort of switchbacks that happen. And I think the markets kind of roll with it. And if anything else, I think the markets have over-anticipated.
Dennis, real quick, last word. Benefit.
One last point on spending. The Republicans won't be able to cut it. They're the guys that passed the drug benefit in Medicare that ran up trillions of dollars in deficit over the next 75 years. When 40% of America does not pay federal income tax and 45% of America receives direct checks from the government, neither party is going to be able to cut spending unless someone gets ready to not get reelected.
I read a great note from JP Morgan this morning about markets. We're going to talk about it a little on later in the show. We're going to take a break. I want to thank, of course, Mark Mattson, founder and CEO of Mattson Money. Always great to have you, sir. Miss Erica Payne from the Agenda Project,
thank
founder.
You.
I know you both have had a long night. Great to have you both with me. All right, coming up, everybody, one German automaker.